My name's Simon Green, and I make music as Bonobo.
Thank you.
Well, the idea of putting together a live show was, it kind of came from when I had started making music. It was probably about 10 years ago now, and I've been just releasing music, and the way I was touring, it was just going out DJing, and people had, well, myself as well, had wanted to try and take it into some sort of live performance. you know, people like the sax player, he's there's a lot of humour in what he does, and I think especially in his solos. If you kind of like watch his solos on slow motion, you can just sort of catch a million references to anything from like sort of daft kind of mid-90s pop music up to, you know, Roland Kirk and all the way in between. So he's got a lot to say for himself.
Thank you.
I think with Dismantling Frank, we've kind of reinvented it. You know, there's elements in there. I think it's obviously very. It's got a different energy live. I mean, and the studio version is very. It's very kind of down tempo. It's very sort of peaceful. Whereas you know, we really get stuck in when we play it live, and especially the saxophone brings you know, a completely different element to it. And I think it's one that can really. It's really progressed as we've played it, and it's been a sort of standard in the set. I mean, tunes have come and gone, but Dismantling Frank has always been, you know, it's always been a part of the set. Been into the idea of well, I've listened to a lot of vocal music, but I've always been into the idea of working with vocalists, but I've never the time has never been right, or the right person has never sort of arisen. It's not an idea that I've always shunned and suddenly decided to get involved this time. But I've always been into the idea. And what I like about vocals is not so much the narrative of the lyric, but more just the texture of the voice and using voices just as another instrument. I think the difference between the three records, because they've been made over a good 5-6 years, the main difference is just I think they reflect a sort of change in taste. Like personally, what I was into then is very different to what I'm into now. So I think my music's going to reflect that, and I try not to to do anything that's to just try not to repeat myself, basically. That's the main goal of each record. But I think you know, I've learned a lot more about production. I've learned a lot more about music and discovered a lot more. So it's trying to just explore sort of ideas and developments in taste and just see which way it goes for each record. worked with a guy called Mike Simmons on the album. He did. I'd kind of written the strings on the keys, and he came and did all the arrangements on tracks like Nightlight and If You Stayed Over. So when I thought of the idea of getting a small string section to come and do some shows with us, Mike was the natural. And I just called him up, and he was just, you know, leave it to me. I'll do all the arrangements. I'll get the players together, and he's got. Two other players, Wayne and Jyoti, he's worked with before, so they worked as a trio, and he took over for the strings and did the arrangements, and then they just turned up at rehearsal and just got stuck in. One day, I think it was actually after we'd done a couple of gigs, we sort of decided to turn off the backing track and just see what would happen if we just tried playing just like a regular 3-4 piece band. And we just found that something just locked in a lot better that way. Even though it kind of sounded a bit more minimal, we could actually just kind of connect a bit better as musicians. We'll be right back. But yeah, I mean, everyone in the band is all, we all sort of known each other before, and I think the main thing is if you can trust someone's taste, that any embellishments that they do are going to be, you know, you don't have to sort of say you need to play this in this style, because this is what we're trying to do. You know, you need to just be able to trust people that they know exactly what, you know, what we're about, and any embellishments they do or ideas they bring to it are just going to be, you know, accepted. So that's a very important thing, because give everyone the freedom to bring their own style and bring their own sound into the band.
Thank you. отправляться в веру.
Yeah, I guess, you know, the bands that, you know, I used to listen to when I was younger were people like, it was like My Bloody Valentine, Can, Ride, some of, who else was there? I mean, there was a whole load of them, but just the idea of getting stuck in and making a big noise without necessarily having to, you know, not necessarily having to be about sort of hype men and leaping about on stage and doing call and response rubbish to the crowd. So I just think that you can sort of be quite, it can be quite sort of an intense experience just from people just belting it out on stage and just really getting into what they're doing.
ladies and gentlemen of Camden Town. Thank you very much for coming out this evening. Been looking forward to this one for a little while now. Before we carry on, I'd like to introduce to you on keys, please give it up for Mr. Simon Capstone Little. Man over here on guitars, please give it up. Ewan Wallace. On strings, Wayne Jote and the magnificent Mr. Mike Simmons. On the back, on the button push and percussion, Mr. Andy Mantronic Wilkins. Mr. Ben Cook on saxophones and assorted sizes. Over here, the man in the shadows, the man with two hands, please give up for Mr. Jack Baker. On vocals, the one and only from Belarus, Miss Catherine DeBar.
Simon Green on bass.
I don't work, you know, purely electronically. I kind of record with microphones and guitars and whatnot. So if I was going to do something live, just kind of looping up my stuff on a laptop in front of an audience wasn't actually an honest representation of what I'm doing in the studio. We'll be right back.
we sure can change the way we live. If we can only take, we've also got to learn to give. Sometimes we're blind. Think with your heart, read between the lines. Sometimes we're lost, sometimes we're blind. Think with your heart, read between the lines.
Night was kind of, it just kind of, it was a bit of a blur, to be honest. There was lots of running about in the day, setting up and panicking, and then on stage, and then it was all over. So it's good that we actually got this live recording to kind of remember what happened, because my memory's not that hot on the night.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've been Bonobo. Thank you very much. Good night. See you next time.